'cause we could be immortals. Immortals, just not for long, for long. Even now, the blackout curtains down. Just not for long, for long.
We could be immortals. Immortals. Welcome back to another exciting episode from Sarah Knight Gaming as we present Beyond Human. Yes, hold the applause. And of course, this episode is still being recorded while under the quarantine. So it's going to sound a little different than we normally do, but you know, we may do what we got. Thank goodness for technology, I tell you that.
So reach out and touch somebody when you can.
We're reaching out in our digital selves right now.
Digital touching.
All right, so setting the scene. You guys are riding along in the Volkswagen. Blue. Baby blue, right?
I think that's what baby blue, some rust. Got my radio on to the news.
Got the radio on and the news just happens to come on. Right? I just want to listen to music.
Seems like that all the time. Every time I turn it on, what's this? What's going on? They're giving me more news.
Yep. All right. So, yeah, they give you the news update on the infections and this new disease that has apparently, spread across the world. So much so that it's been upgraded to pandemic status. And they have named it accordingly Pandemic X. X because there's still so much I do not understand about this virus.
Unsolved quantity.
Exactly. And how it affects everybody differently too. They're still studying it. They're still trying to figure out, you know, how this functions and the best way to treat it. Well, where you guys are at in the Adrianopolis, the infection rate is starting to climb quite heavily. There were some here and there, as was expected for having like a major airport in the city and such. But now the infection rate has begun to skyrocket almost. And so the city is really kind of struggling as far as what it's going to do to contain the situation. But have no fear. Our friends over here at Lie Inc., that is Limit Breaker Industries and Exchange Incorporated.
I trust them already.
They are working on a potential solution. Now, will they have it ready in time? Who knows? Not to mention, you know, you also have these other competing corporations like Steintech and such. Right, Detective?
Stein.
Mm-hmm.
The detective's favorite word, Stein.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the mm-hmm.
That too.
I can't remember my lines. I'm just going to say, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Just shake your head and nod and agree.
Don't do that, though. This is a podcast. So.
So that is the update that you've been given on the virus and what's going on. So they have officially named it. And, of course, a few of you know a little bit more information about what's going on that they're not actually telling everybody else.
Yeah, like they think that it's just now getting out of hand. I mean, come on. What are they talking about? We know that it's been like this for a long time. Ain't that right, Smokey Joe Detective?
First off, don't call me that, please. Second,
Detective or Smokey Joe?
Smoky Joe.
You got it, shooter.
Well, detective, you get a phone call from an unknown number.
Okay.
What do you do?
This better not be a bill collector again.
It's not bill collector. It's student loan corporation.
Ever since my wife left me and I've been living on the beach in that double wide, I've just been getting bill collector call after bill collector call.
Why don't you just tell him Bill doesn't live there anymore?
I don't even know what they want from Bill, but I'll find him and I'll shoot him myself.
No, it's your pandemic ex-relief fund.
Oh, sweet. Mine should be... Wait, I'm on the run.
I answer the call.
All right, you answer the call, and it's a familiar voice. It's that teenager you almost shot. It says, hey, detective.
Yeah, what do you want?
Well, yeah, I have some information for you, so I thought you might want it.
All right, spill it.
Not so easily, not over this tapped line, obviously. I mean, I am talking to a detective.
Yeah?
Tell you what, I'll text you the address. Meet me there, and I'll be able to give everyone more information.
All right.
And then he hangs up.
So, who was that?
No, it's a little fast fella. He wants us to meet him somewhere.
Oh, run away.
So that's his name.
That's kind of what I caught from him right before he went zoom.
Makes sense.
A few minutes later, you get a text message and an address.
All right, so this is the address we're going to. You want to go meet him? He has some information for us.
I say we got to do it. We got to do what we got to do because he already told us we got to meet up. If we're going to find out what's going on.
Indeed.
I'm going to go ahead and put some of the pedal to the metal. It makes a little clunkety clunk noise. And then the Beetle starts going faster.
Sounds great.
Oh, I've been here. I mean, look at this. Motel 6. What's this?
Well, the address belongs to a motel on the outskirts of the city. Of course, this one looks a little more run down than the one I'm presenting to you right now.
Yeah, that's actually one of the cleanest looking Motel 6s I've ever seen.
It's photoshopped a lot.
Yeah. That's for their Yelp review.
Exactly. That's what the Google popped up. Oh, hey, look, guys, Motel 6. Then when you pull up, it's like, that's not the same place.
How is that woman capable of running in stilettos and fishnets?
Face palm. But all right, so that's where you guys pull up to. And of course, when he texted you the address, detective, he gave you the room number as well. You know, 203.
That's on the second floor. I know that.
All right, so let's head up to room 203.
Wait, are we all going to head up there? We're going to make Ghost Girl stay invisible, or we're just going to, like, walk straight up and, like, try to strong-arm this guy?
There's no sense of strong-arming at this point. He's here to give us information. We're going to come and see what he has to say.
You are really trusting detective. I like that about you. Tell you what, Phantom, why don't you stay ghosty ghost just right behind us, just in case something goes wrong.
All right.
I like that you're compliant. That's good.
And maybe someone should have the keys with them.
Yeah, I'll leave the keys in the car with our good friend Hydra here.
All right.
All right. So, Detective and Retrograde, you two are going to head to the room while Phantom is going to remain invisible, correct?
Correct.
Yep.
Sounds great. All right. So, Renegade happily takes the keys and sits in the car.
You better not get a scratch on my car.
And he starts speaking to it, all turns into like water.
I don't want to be in a van anymore. I've been in the van for 20 years. I went in on the action.
All right, so Detective and Retrograde, you guys take the nice little stairs over there at the far end. And you guys go to the second floor, and you know, maybe four doors from the end, you guys find a room that you're looking for.
Does anything look off?
Well, just not a lot of vehicles here. Places run down. Nothing you see kind of looks out of the ordinary for this place. Not for what's being presented.
The door's not ajar. It's not open. Nothing like that.
No.
All right, I'm going to knock on the door.
With your knuckles or like your...
Please not. Like
my knuckles.
Okay.
All right. All right. And a few seconds later, the door opens and behold, it's that kid again.
He is beholden.
He opens the door and sees you, Detective, and he goes, "Ah, Detective, we meet again."
I assume you've already healed up nicely.
Yeah, because the detective sure hasn't.
Detective still has a concussion.
His clothes are still kind of wet.
Yeah, that's right. He hasn't changed yet.
Neither have I. We're both kind of like soppy, moldy.
Yeah, he sees both of you and goes, there's change of clothes in there if you guys need it.
I'll take you up on that.
It's not really in my room anyway, so go for it.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. This isn't like dresses or anything, is it?
No. Actually, there's a nice little Italian suit in here if you want it.
That is now what I'm wearing. It's gray. It feels like satin against my skin. This is the best. I love this. Thanks. You're the coolest guy I've ever met in my life, runway.
What about you, Detective?
I kind of stay in my own clothes.
All right.
My nose appreciates that.
I change my socks.
I remember smelling that when he did that in the car.
Good idea. Good idea there. Squishy, squishy. All right. So as you change Retrograde, he looks at both of you. He says, "All right. Well, guess we go ahead and get down to business here."
That's what we're here for. Detective wants to know answers to questions, and I want to see Sarah.
All right. He goes, "All right, Detective, ask away."
All right, well, you're the one that said you had information. What information do you have?
Well, I arranged a meeting. So, our leader, he wants to talk to you face to face.
Okay.
So take us to your leader.
Absolutely.
Said every alien ever.
He scribbles down an address on a piece of paper and hands it to you, detective. He says, "This is where our leader wants to meet."
Okay. And he said I was in over my head. What were you talking about?
Who you're investigating, this Sarah, she's beyond your pay grade.
Nothing's beyond my pay grade, kid.
Yeah, I'm with him. We can, make more money if we, get promoted.
Well, you see, our leader, he have more info for you on Sarah. See, I only see her every now and then whenever she has a job for me. And ever since you guys showed up, she hadn't been talking to me.
Your organization, what is it?
To us, it's home. Outcasts. People thrown away by society. Like people like me with these abilities that nobody wants to even recognize they even exist. Or these government institutions want to sit there and throw us into a lab and start dissecting us. Yeah.
That's true. That's true. They do that.
Like Stein. What about Stein Corps? What do you have on them?
Yeah, Stein Corps? Think about it, man. Leader in military technology combined with the abilities that we have, what could you do with it?
Can I take a look at the prototype rifle that I stole and see if it's got any kind of a stamp on it?
Are you looking for a serial number?
Yeah, maybe it says Stein Corps 00 something.
Yeah. Yeah, and it does. It says that, a little on the hilt of it, on the butt of the rifle, has the Stein Corps stamp.
I look at the kid and I tell him, "Tell me something I don't know."
Or tell him something that he doesn't already suspect. Because he's kind of squirrely, sitting at home. Is microwave Dennis.
Well, I mean, if you want more information, then our leader, he'd be the one to ask.
I think that's what we should do. Let's go see this guy, find out what he knows about Sarah. This whole situation.
What I can tell you is that my job is a runner. I wasn't just working for the shelter. I was delivering packages.
Naturally, you'd be a runner.
Well, because he runs, right? That's what we meant by that. Yeah, naturally. I agree with the detective.
Well, this is where I leave, guys. So, there's your address. You want more information? He'd be glad to see you. In the meantime, I gotta run.
See you, Tommy. Runway.
And then he's just he opens the door. And as soon as he opens the door, he kind of tips his hat to you without having a hat. And he's gone.
All right. So you got the address. Let's get to it. Let's get back down to the good old fashioned Volkswagen. And let's peel out. Let's do what we need to do.
I agree. Let's go.
All right. So you guys get back to the Volkswagen. And at this point, by the way, Phantom, what are you doing?
I'm still invisible, just going behind it. Well,
just following?
Yes, after. Yeah, just following them.
Okay, cool. Gotcha. Now, as you're following, you guys get back to the Volkswagen. So Renegade, he steps out, and you can tell that he's not looking right. Like, before, you thought he was just messing with you when he was just talking to you, and it sounded like he was underwater. But it looks like he's having a problem controlling his form, because he steps out, and then the only words that you can hear him say is, "I don't feel so good."
Hey, yo, Water Bison, what's wrong with you, man?
And then before you realize it, like, he just completely turns into water form. And then hits the ground, and then basically goes into the sewer drain.
Oh, snap. That's going to get hard to get him back. I'm going to miss that guy.
That's going to be unpleasant for him. Oof.
You're talking about, I'm still the one smelling you. You're refusing to change clothes.
Maybe you should swing by his apartment so he can change clothes.
he just scowls at me all the time. I don't even. This is a great relationship. I enjoy this. Well, I guess we can't really get him back. I mean, we could yell at the sewer grate for a while if we wanted to.
That's something to worry about later. Right now, we need to get to the address and get this information.
Because it's not like he can drown or nothing.
And if we have to interrogate somebody, I can just threaten to wrap them up in my coat.
That is a good threat. Yeah. We'll rely on that. That'll be the crutch. Let's go ahead and just hop in the old Beetle. Is Ghost Girl here? Ghost Girl!
Yep.
Yep. You there?
Get in the car. Everybody get in the car.
All right.
Don't mind the smell.
Yeah, that's just the detective.
All right, so you guys get in the car, and where are you heading?
Just drive with the windows open so you can, dry it out.
Yeah, air dry.
That's my stealth car. Yeah, what's the address? What borough am I driving to?
Let's see. Actually, the address is not too far from your location. So as you guys pull up to the little GPS, it turns out that it's an old church and hadn't been used in years.
Well, that's really freaking creepy.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
It's a little foreboding. A historic building.
And for once, we finally agree about stuff.
So as you guys are traveling, this is an opportunity for you to, discuss with each other, kind of plans or just learn a little more about each other. So go for it.
So, how long you been divorced?
Mm-hmm. I have not been married. I haven't had time to settle down with anybody.
Yeah, nobody warming up to the old charm.
Nobody that lasts today.
I can see that. You keep things close to the vest, that's what I mean. So, what are we going to do? Are we just going to run in here, do this thing? What's your thing anyway?
My thing?
Yeah, your thing.
What thing?
The thing that you do.
The thing that I do?
Yeah, everybody's got a thing.
I'm a detective.
Well, yeah, I get it. you're like an old, what do they call you, gumshoe. I'm a jarhead. I mean, they have names for people. I'm talking about the thing that you do after you got sick.
I use armor and technology to channel energy that I expound.
Yeah, well, I'm in technology. Still works, even after it gets soaking wet and beaten around by a big water guy that fades away into the sewer. I'll believe anything nowadays, I guess. I mean, I'd tell you what I could do, but then again, if I did, I could just go back and not tell you.
That is true. I kind of gathered that you manipulate time somehow. At least that's what I suspect.
That's good suspicion. But suspicions, well, you know, they can lead us wrong. I don't know. Maybe we'll find out. Maybe we'll trust each other. Maybe you'll keep lying to me. I don't know.
I already told you what I did. I used armor to channel my energy.
Yeah. And I used my BS meter to say, yeah, it's off the charts. That's cool. What do you want to do when we get to the church?
Anyways, when we get to the church, I figure we can have the kid stay out here or come with us and just kind of scope the area out and make sure there's not any threats.
I mean, yeah, she's kind of invisible. She's kind of handy. That's why I keep her around. She can even do this thing with her face where it turns into sloppy mush and then comes back and looks like somebody else.
I know I need to stay in the same radius as you for you to use your powers.
Maybe.
I mean, that's what I gathered from what I saw from the vehicle suddenly disappearing and reappearing behind us. Me slowing down.
Whatever happened to that vehicle?
Maybe. That was a pretty nice ride. See here, I thought your car was just made out of something special. It could do that, you know? I didn't even really know what was going on, man. I got in, it drove me away. It stole me, man.
Sure.
All right, so then we get Ghost Girl, well, Phantom, my sidekick. She'll go in unseen, keep an eye on things, maybe from the loft. I'll let her use my rifle. That way I look unarmed. And they'll be more trusting when we first walk in, right? Just in case it's a trap. Set up.
Yeah.
You hear all that, Phantom? Did she get in the car? Did I forget to get the... Oh, man. Do we have to go back and get her?
I got that.
Oh, there she is. Man. Where'd you go? I thought you were gone for a second. Like the water man.
No, not gone.
Just not talkative. I've met a whole lot of teenage girls that are a lot less talkative. That's true. It's believable. So look. I keep forgetting
that I'm muted.
I'm going to let you use my rifle, but be careful. It's a prototype. You're going to sneak into the church building, and you're gonna get the drop on anybody if they get shifty with us.
I can do that.
You can't do that, right?
I can do that.
Okay, you sound kind of somewhat, maybe confident. I'm okay with that. Yeah, this seems like a good plan.
All right, sounds like an interesting plan. So we will see how that unfolds when we return.